Welcome to Afrikunya TV News Update. My name is Deborah Eze. Now starting off, the president of the Chad and Transition, General Mahamat Idriss Deby Itno, ended his first two-day visit to Brazzaville on Sunday. The Congolese president, Denis Sassou Nguesso, in his capacity as the current president of the Economic Community of Central African States, called upon the various Chadian actors to participate in the future inclusive dialogue in the country. ECCAS also welcomed the intentions of the Chadian Transitional Authorities to accept to involve the various armed groups in the national reconciliation process. Moving on, the former Ivorian First Lady, Simone Gbagbo, attended the launch event of a political movement to support her, a step further towards creating her own political party for the 2025 presidential election. She emphasized a vision of a strong, sovereign, reconciled, modern, and prosperous Cote d'Ivoire, hammering out the national motto, union, discipline, and work. And also Rwanda President Paul Kagame visited the northern Mozambican province of Cabo Delgado to reaffirm the importance of collaboration between the two countries. Kagame met with President Yusi and reaffirmed that the conflict in northeastern Mozambique against armed jihadist group marked by some successes of joint Mozambican and Rwandan forces is in a consolidation phase. In Mali, Prime Minister Choguel Kokala Maiga accused France of abandoning conflict on country with his decision to draw down troops this year. Maiga told the UN General Assembly that he regretted the unilateral announcement, which he said justified his government seeking other partners, in an apparent reference to Mali having asked private Russian companies to boost security in the conflict on country. And in Tunisia, hundreds of protesters took to the streets of Tunisian capital yesterday, demanding the country's constitution be respected and parliament reinstated. In July, Saïd decided to sack the country's prime minister, suspend parliament whose power are now frozen, and assume executive authority, saying it was because of a national emergency. And the Nigerians buried the victim of a jihadist attack. At least 8 soldiers were killed and several others missing after being ambushed by IS-affiliated jihadists in violence-wrecked northeast Borno State. A military convoy came under rocket fire by Islamic State West African province militants as it made its way between the town of Dikwa and Matay in the Lake Chad region. 8 other soldiers and an anti-jihadist militant man were injured in the attack. Still in Nigeria, despite ongoing amnesty and other measures to address crude theft in Niger Delta region and over 32 billion naira paid between January and July on pipeline security and maintenance costs, Nigeria's production challenges appear unabated, as frequent pipeline sabotage is expected to see the country's average crude loss surpass 200,000 barrels a day. An update from the foreign scene, Germany's Social Democrats were set today to start the process of trying to form a government after they narrowly won their first national election since 2005 to end 16 years of conservative-led rule under Angela Merkel. The center-left Social Democrats SPD won 25.7% of the votes ahead of 24.1% for Merkel's CDU's /CSU conservative bloc. According to provisional results, the Greens came in at 14.8% and the Liberal Free Democrats FDP were on 11.5%. And still in Europe, a magnitude of 6.5 earthquake struck the Greek island of Crete, according to the European Mediterranean Seismological Center. The quake has a depth of 1.24 miles, the EMC said. And in sports, Pep Guardiola insists Bernardo Silva is happy at Manchester City, but has hinted the midfielder could choose to leave the club in the future. The Portuguese international, who has 4 years remaining on the City contract, was linked with a departure from the Etihad Stadium during the last transfer window amid suggestions that the 100 million euros arrival of Jack Grealish could see his first team opportunities limited this season. And last but not the least, Arsenal's emphatic North London derby win over Tottenham Hotspur finally saw the Gunners at something close to their final form. After all those dark days and the times when Arteta faced intense criticism from all quarters, the Spaniard surely felt some level of vindication after such a complete performance. It hasn't always been clear what the process entails, but Mikel Arteta always maintained that the work being done behind the scene at the Emirates Stadium would eventually lead to something tangible and better. And that's the news update. You can also catch us on Joy Team and Pangram to catch up with our news and programs. Many thanks for watching. I'm Deborah Eze. Bye for now.